Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss about the energy balance about heat exchanger. So normally we have learned about the energy balances and mass balances in different subjects like stoichiometry or process calculation and in some fundamentals concepts as well as in heat and mass transfer now. So in the heat transfer area, we have to focus on the energy balance. So what exactly the energy balance? So for that purpose, assume a heat exchanger. So that heat exchanger may be of any type. That may be double pipe heat exchanger, that may be shell and tube heat exchanger, that may be scrap type heat exchanger, spiral heat exchanger, whatever it may be. But the main principle of this heat exchanger is to exchange the heat. So the purpose of this heat exchanger may be heating, maybe cooling, maybe vaporizing, maybe condensing, whatever it may be. We have to focus for this purpose, we have to focus only on the inlet and outlets and the energies related to that inlet and outlet, right? So first we must consider this heat exchanger. So in the heat exchanger, obviously there are two fluids. One is hot fluid and one is cold fluid. So here I have mentioned this arrow, it means it is an inlet of hot fluid, right? So hot fluid in, and the temperature of this hot fluid in is TH1 or THI. So the symbol may be different in different reference books. So for this purpose, we are going to assume this TH1, right? And the mass flow rate of this hot fluid is M dot H, right? So this H stands for hot fluid, M stands for mass flow rate, and it is in terms of kg per hour, kg per second. So I have put this dot, right? So hot fluid in, the temperature is TH1 and mass flow rate is M dot H. Now hot fluid out. So this is the outlet of this hot fluid and the temperature is TH2 and the mass flow rate is one and the same. So the temperature is changing, enthalpy is changing, mass flow remain same. Now on the cold fluid side, cold fluid in, so this is the inlet of this cold fluid, the temperature is TC1 and the mass flow rate is M dot C. So again, C stands for cold, so 1 stands for inlet, 2 stands for outlet, and this M stands for mass flow rate, right? So this is the TC1 and M dot C are the parameters as far as the cold fluid in is concerned. In a similar way, cold fluid out. So this is the outlet. For that outlet, TC2 is the temperature and M dot C is the mass flow rate, right? So if we consider this mass flow rate in out and temperatures in out of the hot fluid and cold fluid. So what exactly happen in the heat exchangers? So we know that the heat is given out by hot fluid. So here I have written heat is given out by hot fluid. So the temperature of hot fluid is obviously higher. That is why we are called is at as a hot fluid. So naturally that high temperature to low temperature transfer of heat is there. So the heat is given out by this hot fluid, right? So exactly equal to heat is gained by the cold fluid. So we are assuming here it is a steady state temperature, then there are no losses of heat, and on the basis of this assumption we have write this equation that is called as energy balance, that heat is given out by the hot fluid is equal to the gain by the cold fluid. So whatever the heat given out by this hot fluid can be gained by the cold fluid. Obviously practically in the industrial examples there are heat losses, but for this purpose, for this equation, we are not going to consider the heat losses. We are consider that heat losses are negligible, right? So on the basis of this, we can write that heat is given out by the hot fluid represented by the Q suffix H, right? So we know that Q is nothing but the rate of heat transfer. So QH stands for the rate of heat transfer of the hot fluid. And this Q again, rate of heat transfer, but it is of cold fluid, right? So why this minus and plus sign are there? So this heat is given out by the hot fluid. So this hot fluid loses its heat That is why this minus sign is there. And this cold fluid gains the heat. That is why it is plus sign. So plus sign or no sign, obviously nothing but the gain by the heat, gain by the cold fluid heat, right? So given out, that is why minus sign is important. So on the basis of this Q, so now what is the rate of heat transfer? The rate of heat transfer can be defined in terms of enthalpies or in terms of sensible and latent heat. There are different ways. So on the basis of equation given or the data given, we can calculate the rate of heat transfer. And the basic formula for this Q is M delta H, right? So on the basis of this basic formula, we have written this for the hot fluid M dot H. Now this M is general, but now in this case it is of hot fluid. So M dot H, then delta H. So the enthalpy difference, that is HH2 minus HH1, right? And this minus sign is same, right? In the same way, on the cold fluid side, a QC can be defined in terms of M delta H again. So this M here, M dot C, because it is a mass flow rate of the cold fluid, and delta H can be written as HC2 minus HC1, right? So we have put this M delta H terminologies in terms of this equation on the basis of this rate of heat transfer principle. So this minus sign can be multiplied through this bracket, and this becomes HH1 minus HH2, right? So this minus into HH2, that is why here minus, this minus minus plus, so SH1 and minus HH2. So the right hand side is one and the same. Now this is the one of the equation where we can calculate the unknown parameters from the energy balance. Now we can also calculate the different parameters or unknown parameters where the sensible heat is there. So what exactly the sensible heat is? The heat which involves the increase in temperature or decrease in temperature, that may be heating or cooling, but where the phase change does not take place, that is called as sensible heat. So which can sense easily by our body is called as sensible heat. So where heating is required, where cooling is required, but no phase change, then it is called as sensible heat. Say for example, when I mixed the hot fluid, hot water of 65 degrees Celsius at normal atmospheric pressure with the cold fluid, which is at 20 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure. Now, if the hot fluid is at 65 degrees Celsius and the cold fluid is at 20 degrees Celsius, obviously the heat is transferred from 65 degrees Celsius fluid to the 20 degrees Celsius fluid. But there is a no condensation, no vaporization, nothing. So no phase change takes place, because at atmospheric pressure for the water, freezing point is 0 degrees Celsius. So it is not going to convert into solid, and boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius. So it is not going to convert into vapor also. So only heat transfer takes place, and that is from 65 degrees Celsius hot fluid to the cold fluid at 20 degrees Celsius. So only cooling is there, or vice versa case, only heating is there. So if the heating and cooling are there, then we can calculate this rate of heat transfer, this Q, in terms of MCP delta T. So normally when we are talking about this sensible heat, we are generally write it as MCP delta T, right? So just like this M delta H in terms of enthalpy, we can write the rate of heat transfer in terms of Cp, right? That is specific heat or heat capacity. So we can write this equation in terms of MCP delta T. So Q in terms of MCP delta T. So for the hot fluid, what is M? So it is M dot H. What is Cp for hot fluid? So it is Cp suffix H. Then for delta T purpose, TH1 minus TH2. In the similar way, for the cold fluid purpose, it is MCP delta T again, but here M is replaced by M dot C, Cp is replaced by CPC, and this delta T is replaced by TC2 minus TC1. So here 2 minus 1 is there, but the minus sign is multiplied, and that is why it becomes TH1 minus TH2, right? So for the sensible heat calculation, we can use this equation, that is MHCPH in bracket TH1 minus TH2 or equal to MCPCPC TC2 minus TC1, and all or both the equation or the numerical values for this equation are one and the same, and that is nothing but the Q, right? So the rate of heat transfer can be calculated with the help of these cold fluid parameters or with the help of hot fluid parameters. So in the numerical, sometimes it is given that one unknown is there and other are known, and we have to calculate that unknown particular. That may be the temperature of one of the fluid, right? So for the latent heat now, so what exactly the latent heat is? So we know that in the sensible heat, there is no phase change takes place, only heating or cooling is there. But in the latent heat, there is a phase change, that may be vaporization, that may be condensation, that may be freezing, whatever it may be. But the temperature is constant, pressure is constant, and still heat transfer takes place. So that concept is nothing but the latent heat. So generally, we are supplying the steam as a heating media in the industry, and we get some heating fluid, right? So for that purpose, we have to calculate this rate of heat transfer on the basis of m lambda. So the general concept or the formula is m lambda for the latent heat transfer. So for this QH, we can write this m dot h lambda, and here mcp delta t. So why it is written as like this? Now in this case, we are going to consider that hot fluid, it means steam. So vaporizing or condensing steam. So this condensing steam is given out its heat to the cold fluid. Now this cold fluid temperature is increases from TC1 to TC2, right? So as far as the cold fluid is concerned, only temperature change is there. There is no phase change. So this equation is in terms of sensible heat, that is MCP delta T. But as far as this steam is concerned, or condensing steam is concerned, it is in terms of latent heat, because after given out the latent heat from the steam, that vapors or the steam is going to convert into condensate. It means it is into liquid form. So vapors are converted into liquid. That is, steam is going to convert into condensate. And that is why here the equation is in terms of latent heat, that is m lambda. In this case, only heating is there, and there is no phase change. That is why this cold fluid equation is written in terms of MCP delta T. So we can calculate this rate of heat transfer on the basis of this equation or on the basis of this equation. And sometimes in numericals, again, one unknown is given, others are known. So we can equate this equation, or we can equate this equation, and we can find the unknown, whatever they require. So this is the simple energy balance equation, where we can use the sensible heat concept, we can use the latent heat concept, and we can use the enthalpy change concept. So the basic formula for the rate of heat transfer is m delta H, then mcp delta T, and m lambda. So depending on the condition, we can assume the equations, and we must know the inlets and outlet parameters for this purpose. So if you know these temperatures in and out, if you know this mass flow rate of hot and cold fluid, then we can easily find out the unknown from the numericals, right? So on the basis of this energy balance equation, let us calculate one of the unknown parameter from the numerical, right? So take the numerical. I will give you the parameters which are given in the numerical, and you have to calculate the unknown parameter, right? So write down the thermic fluid heater the example of thermic fluid heater flowing at a rate of 5000 kg per hour. Now here it is heat exchanger. Thermic fluid means hot fluid flowing from
or sir pahile pasun sanga na
at a rate of 5000 kg per hour. Thermic fluid flowing at a rate of 5000 kg per hour is to be cooled from 423 Kelvin to 363 Kelvin. By circulating water at a rate of at a rate of 15,000 kg per hour. If the water is available, at 303 Kelvin, find the outlet temperature of water. The data is given, that is specific heat of thermic fluid is equal to 2.72 kilojoules per kgK. And Cp of water Four point 187 kilojoules per kgK. So here we can solve this problem. So what exactly given? What is to be calculated? It is simple that inlet and outlet temperatures are given, then the mass flow rate of thermic fluid as well as cold fluid, that is nothing but the water, is given. The temperature of inlet of water, that is inlet of cold fluid, is given, and we have to ask that calculate the temperature of outlet of water, right? So we know the equations where only sensible heat is there, because in this example they haven't mentioned that there is a phase change takes place or enthalpies are given. Only Cp is given. It means it is clearly on the basis of sensible heat calculations, right? So what exactly the equation is there? So we can use this equation, right? So what is that equation for the sensible heat? MH CpH TH1 minus TH2 equal to एमसी सीपीसी टीसी टू माइनस टीसी वन. So this is the equation what we have discussed in the energy balance equation, and on the basis of this equation we have to calculate this TC2. So this TC2 is unknown and other parameters are known, so just we have to observe that all the things are in SI. So here temperature is in Kelvin, then the mass flow rate is in kg per hour, and this Cp is in terms of kg, in terms of K. So there is no need of unit conversion, just we have to put the values. So what is the m dot h? So this thermic fluid is nothing but the m dot h. The value is 5000 kg per hour. Then cph value is given, that is 2.72 kilojoules per kg K. Then this th1 minus th2. So this is the inlet TH1 and this is the outlet TH2. So what is value? 423 minus 363 Kelvin equal to, now the value of MC. So what is the mass flow rate? This 15,000 kg per hour into CPC. So the value is 4.187 kilojoules per kg K. Then TC2. So TC2 is unknown, right, as it is, and TC1 is given, that is 303 Kelvin. Right? So if you think this kg per hour, kg per hour, kilojoules per kgk, kilojoules per kgk, Kelvin, Kelvin. So no need of unit conversion. So you can directly calculate this TC2 in terms of Kelvin with the help of shift solve method in the scientific calculator. Or you can conventionally calculate this TC2. You have to calculate this left hand side, then you have to calculate this right hand side parameters. This is unknown, and you can calculate this TC2, and the TC2 value is near about 316 Kelvin. So on the basis of given parameters or data in the numerical, first thing is you have to find out whether it is on the basis of sensible heat calculation, whether it is on the basis of latent heat calculation, or whether it is on the basis of enthalpy calculation. Then we can use this equation, appropriate equation, and we can put the values, and simultaneously you have to observe the units. All the units are in a same method or in only SI units. If not, then you have to convert this into SI unit, and we have to calculate the value of this temperature or whatever the unknown is given. Okay, I think you understand the energy equation as well as you are capable to calculate this temperature value. Thank you.